Hello, good morning all of you. So we completed our first chapter about the cell. We are going to start the next chapter, that's about the tissues. So the term tissue, we know about that. Tissue means a group of cells. So what type of group? A group of cells with the same structure, same size and same origin, then we can call it as a tissue. And also all the cells of this tissue perform similar function also. So such kind of cells, such kind of groups of cells are called tissues. So tissues, in this chapter we are going to study about the different types of tissues. Tissues in plants and animals. We know that plants and animals, they differ in their basic design, body design. A number of differences are there exhibited by the plants and animals in their basic body design. What are the main differences you can say? A number of other, the important ones are the plants. In case of plants, most of the cells are supportive in function. Most of the cells are supportive in function. That means the cells are giving structural support to the plants. That's why most of the cells are dead in case of plants. And also in case of animals, all the cells are living. Most of the cells are living. Only one or two cells present in some of the parts, hairs, nails, etc. They are only dead, or the outer layer of skin. That's only the dead ones. All others are living ones. And also we can see growth is exhibited by both plants and animals. But some difference in their growth. In case of plants, we can see only some of the plant parts are growing fastly. The tip of the shoot is growing fastly. The tip of the root is growing fastly. Okay, but in case of animals, the growth is uniform in all parts of the body. Okay, all parts of the body, they are growing uniformly only up to a certain period of time. That we studied in the 7th, 8th standard. Okay, after reaching the adolescence, after completing the adolescence, there will be no growth in case of animals. Human beings are other kind of animals also. But in case of plants, the growth is lifelong. Not all the body parts, but only some of the parts of the plant. So we can say, in plants, the growth is localized. Whereas in animals, the growth is uniform throughout the body. And also, plants are not moving at all. Okay, there is not much movement exhibited by the plants. That's why the requirement of energy for plant cells, that's very less compared to that of the animals. So these are the main differences between, a number of differences are there, but some of the these important differences between the plants and animals are there. That's why the tissues in plants and animals, they are also differ. So we have to study what are the major plant tissues and also animal tissues. First of all, the plant tissues. Plant tissues are mainly classified into two. They are the meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Meristematic tissues and permanent tissues. Permanent. Meristematic tissues and permanent tissues. First of all, we can see what is this meristematic tissue. Meristematic tissue or meristem, that is present in the growing areas of the plant. Growing areas of the plant. They are the actively dividing cells. They are the actively dividing cells. We know what is cell division. That means at the time of growth, if it is the growth in height or growth in weight, what is happening? The old cell is dividing and producing new cells. Okay. So in case of this meristematic tissue, they are present in the growing areas. That means the meristematic tissues, they are showing fast cell division. Able to divide very fastly. Okay. And also the cells of this meristematic tissue, they are usually living. All the meristematic cells are living with the thick cytoplasm is there, and also a thin cell wall. A thin cell wall is also the cell wall, cytoplasm, everything we studied there in the first chapter. So what type of cells are there? Actively dividing cells, all are living with a thin layer, with a thin cell wall and a thick cytoplasm. Living protoplasm is there inside in the cell. Okay, and where they are located? They are located in the growing areas of the plant. So based on the location in a plant body, we have to classify this meristematic tissues into three categories. How many are the three main categories of meristematic tissues are there? How we classified them? On the basis of the location in a plant body. Okay, we can see what are the three main classifications of this meristematic tissue. So first of all, when we are considering this as a shoot tip, we can see this a shoot. We can see a shoot means a branch of the stem with the leaves, flowers, and also fruits. So the first category of meristematic tissue that we can see in this tipary areas. This is the tip of the shoot. Or these are the tips. This is also another tip of the shoot. Okay. So here we can see the first location of meristem. This is what is called apical meristem. What is name? Apical meristem. The second location of this meristematic tissue that we can see almost parallel to the long axis of the stem. Here we can see. So this is the name given lateral meristem. Apical meristem, lateral meristem. And the third category of this meristem that we can see in this nodes or internodes. In this regions we can see the third category of this meristem. That is called a intercalary meristem. So three types of meristems are the apical meristem, lateral meristem, and intercalary meristem. So apical meristem is usually present in the growing tip regions of the plant. Shoot tip, root tip, and also buds. We can see what is a bud. Bud is present usually in the axil of this leaf. Here we can see the buds. So here also what is present there? Apical meristem is present. So apical meristem which can bring about being this position which can bring about an increase in the length of the plant. What is the main function of this apical meristem? Which can bring about an increase in the length of the plant. So 3 points you have studied based on one meristem. This apical meristem location, function, and what will happen to this apical meristem later. That means in future. So what is the location of apical meristem? That is in the root apex or shoot apex. Apex means tip, growing tip. Then what is the function? Bring about an increase in the length of the plant. Then which will become the permanent tissue after cell differentiation? After cell differentiation. A new term, cell differentiation. Cell differentiation means the process by which one cell receives a suitable specific function for a cell, then we can call it is the cell differentiation. So the process of conversion of meristematic tissue into permanent tissue, that also we can say cell differentiation. So after cell differentiation, all the meristematic tissues which will becomes a permanent tissue. So after permanent tissue, there will be no division at all. They have a special duty in a plant body. They have a special role there. They occupy this forms a special shape. There will be no change in the shape in future. Okay. After becoming a permanent tissue. So the process of conversion of meristematic tissue into a permanent tissue, that is called a cell differentiation. That means after cell differentiation, we can't call this tissue is a meristematic tissue. At that time, that will be a permanent tissue. About permanent tissues, we will study after this. Okay. So, what are the 3 points? Apical meristem located in the tip region, bring about an increase in the length of the plant, which will become a permanent tissue after cell differentiation. The second one is the lateral meristem. That is present almost parallel to the long axis of the stem. Parallel is the location. Parallel to the long axis of the stem. So, being that location, usually which can bring about an increase in the thickness of the plant, girth of the plant, or thickness of the plant, that is the main function of this lateral meristem. This also which will becomes the after cell differentiation, this lateral meristem which will becomes a permanent tissue. The name of the permanent tissue, that is the cambium, which will becomes the cambium of the plant. Then third one is the intercalary meristem. Intercalary meristem is present in the internodes or What is my internode? The space between two nodes is called internode. This is one node and this is also another node. So the space between this internodes, two nodes, is called the internode. So in this internodal area, what we can see? The intercalary meristem. This can bring about an increase in the length of the plant, and this will become the permanent tissue after cell differentiation. So these are the details regarding the three types of meristem. Based on with the help of this diagram, we can study more easily about the location and function of the three types of meristematic tissue. The remaining we'll discuss in next class. Okay.